Hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to today's video where I'm going to chat about my party palettes. I have palettes here that make me think of, well, the holidays, but also New Year's, parties, my idea of the festivities. Let's just say that. Let me start off by saying happy holidays. And I have an announcement to make because it's Christmas weekend. And I know that most of my audience is from the USA and you have Christmas Eve and Christmas Day, right? Well, we are extra because my family has Christmas Eve, which is today or tonight. But we have two Christmas days, so that's the entire weekend. So because of that, there will be no new makeup releases tomorrow, but there will be a video. And it is a very fun video. If I say so myself, it's going to be a weird collabs. Of this year. I had a lot of fun filming it and I hope that you enjoy it. But today, first off, let's talk about my 10 perfect party palettes. I have grouped everything by brand and yeah, let's just get started. I have some PR, I have some bought, I also have discount codes. I'll let you know. Let's start with actually one that I pulled last minute, which was maybe a little bit surprising. It's from Catrice and it is this one, the Pro Vintage Soul. When I open this one up, I am like, yeah, it is. You know, I can do a gray smoky eye here, which I love, especially my go-to party look. What can I say? And then for the rest, it's, I don't know, the day after Christmas or the day after, you know, January 1st, when you kind of want to have something fun on your eyes, but you don't want to make a big effort. If I'm not mistaken, this is also available in the USA right now. I really, really like this palette. And I just need to bust it out more because these types of tones, I really, really love this time of year as well. Okay. Then I'm going to go to Unique Beauty. These palettes were sent to me. I have one palette that was sent to me in PR from Unique Beauty. And it is this one. It's the Tis the Season. It is from her last collection, which was basically a holiday collection. This palette for me, it's very, very much a Christmassy palette. So here it is. You know, with the gifts and all that. And then when you open her up, and it's also the shade names. This makes me think of Christmas. Quality is amazing. You can go nice and basically traditional. You can go neutral. You can go again a party time and then the day after. Whatever floats your boat. And again, I really, really love the quality. I do have a discount code with Unique Beauty. It is affiliated. It will be listed down below. Then the next one is more. Well, I don't know. This one feels a little bit more maybe Christmas Day. Or something like that. This is then kind of the maybe even the Christmassy evening party palette. Or maybe even for New Year's. And it's from their Japan collection. Also Unique Beauty. It's the volume 2. Now look at this. With the floating lanterns. The outside is stunning. Then when you open her up. Look how stunning. It's perfect to combine with the previous palette that I showed you. And this is just. And then especially that shade. Shade Floating Lantern. Can we just appreciate the gorgeousness that is that shade? It's stunning. It's just such a unique color that I have in my collection. The next palette that I pulled, it's basically my holiday palette. It's one of my favorites that I have in my collection. And every time I open up this palette, it makes me think of Christmas, of Yuletide, of Bad Santa. Basically, let me show you. It's from 5050 Makeup. It's the winter palette from last year. This is just. I could have used this palette actually for my look today. I didn't, but I could have. Because the only thing is that this doesn't have the darker matte that I have here. but you can get a very, very similar vibe. I actually have the chestnut tote from Sigil on my eyes right now. But this palette, it's just such a grungy, Christmassy feeling. I love this palette. And I need to bust it out again. Because I really want to play with this again. And this shade in the middle, which is for a lot of people a pretty neutral shade. For me, can you see how orange it turns? I have an olive complexion. So for me, it turns even more orange. And it's a very warm, toasty, well, basically orangey brownie neutral shade then. But I love it. It is the oldest palette that I have here in my collection and still a favorite. And that is saying something, isn't it? Then the next palette that I'm going to mention, it's actually the first palette of this brand that I tried, which is from Alien Cosmetics. It was their Halloween release from last year, but it is still a very, very Christmassy palette for me. And that is this one. Now, it has been revamped. This was done in collaboration with Serendipity Artist. It has been revamped. So the outside is different. I think the gold is gone. But also, yeah, I don't know. It just makes it extra festive, I think, at least. I think she also reformulated this. So now they have square pans. But this is the first one that I tried from her. And then with the exception of the yellow, this is such a Christmassy color story. The mattes are very, very nice. They work beautifully. They layer, they blend. And then the shimmers that are in here are just stunning. You have a red shimmer that's a little bit more of your old school traditional shimmer. And then this shade. This is a duochrome. This is a green with a red in it. This is a topper shade. It's just such a cool palette. And very, very this time of year, for me at least. Okay, now I'm going to go basically to the last real Christmassy palette, and then I'm going to go a little bit more into the what I consider more party palettes, a little bit more towards New Year's or something like that. Or if you're just going to go out and you want to look all vampy and such. Let's start with this palette. This is, again, PR. This is from Nomad Cosmetics. It's their Home for the Holiday palette. This says, this alone says holiday, right? Then when you open her up, you have an almost all shimmer palette. Only the black is a matte. But you can do, again, very, very Christmassy looks with these. This red, it's one of my favorite reds in my collection. But also this peach, it's an orangey, goldeny, greeny, stunning. And what's, you know, especially this time of year, with all the bling and all the glittery bits, and it's an, you know, perfect companion palette for the holidays, for every time of year actually, but especially for the holidays. And then with the theme, I think it's a perfect holiday palette. Then I'm kind of going to transition a little bit now. So for me, the next palette that I pulled, it's a palette that is surprisingly, what's the word? That I use a surprising amount of time. That was actually it. And I did not really expect this to. It's, for me, it's become kind of an everyday palette. But I wanted to pull this one in because I think it's a perfect companion to the previous palette that I mentioned. And I also want to have something for, you know, during the day. When you are like, I kind of want to do something, but I don't want to make a huge effort. Then I think this palette is perfect. And then you can even spruce it up if you want to later in the day or in the evening. It's this one, also from Nomad Cosmetics. It's the Venice Simple and Express. It's basically the mini version of their Orient Express. And also this, it just feels, I don't know what it is with the whole, I think it's because of the movies that I watched when I was younger, but the Orient Express for me, it just screams this time of year. It's, I don't know why. I just want to drink champagne and toast to the new year in the Orient Express. I don't know. It is just the way it is. It's the whole feeling. You know, it's, what can I say? And then when you open her up, it's this. So it's a pretty neutral color story, but still you can really spruce it up. You have, again, you have a green shimmer, you have a red matte that you can combine with the shimmer palette from Nomad. And then this shade, it's kind of a toppery style shade, but it also has a multi-dimensional goodness in it. Depending on the shade that you use it on top, it just transforms it. So it is one of my favorite shades in this palette as well. And then with the gold, for me that, yeah, gold, but also a little bit more of the dirty gold, is just very much New Year's. I don't, it's, I think, a perfect palette for this time of year. Hell, for every time of year, because I am actually using it quite a bit. So now I'm going to go to palettes that scream New Year's for me. And for me, kind of my almost, I want to say almost perfect party palette. And with party palette, if I'm going to go out clubbing, which I'm not anymore, there is just something about a black smoky eye. right? There is just something about that that makes it the ultimate glamour. For me, it was always the unicorn eye look. I always wanted to do it. I never could because my skill set was not there. And that was before I had my YouTube channel. And yeah, basically it looked okay until the lights came on. Then it was... Yeah, so for me, that signifies as the ultimate party look. But let's go to this one first, which is from Makeup Obsession. It's the Smoking Palette. This is one of their very, very tiny palettes. You get 9 shades. And as you can see, it is a gray-black palette. You have 2 true mattes and you have some satin. So the black is a matte. The shade Charcoal, which is a dark gray, is also a matte. Then this one... Sultry is a satin, and then the rest are shimmery shades. here's the middle shade. And it is just, again, stunning. It transforms all the shades. You can really, really spruce it up. This is just such a surprising little palette. The quality is very, very good. The mattes, they build very well. They blend beautifully. I don't even know how many people know about this palette, but it's just such a stunning palette. And it's very, very tiny. So if you go to a friend's house because you're going to go out clubbing, this is very, very easy to chuck in your bag, you know? Then the next palette is my... If I want to do a gray smoky eye, this is the palette that I grab. I have been known to use it all through the year. Depending on kind of my mood and the season we are in, I combine it with different colors. So for instance, in summer, I like to use this with neons. Right now, around this time of year, Christmas for instance, I like to combine it with red. Because I think that's stunning. And then, you know, for New Year's Eve look, you can combine it with a little bit of gold. You can keep it the way it is. You know, it's the Blown Smoke from Colourpop. Maybe this is even my... Is it my favorite Colourpop palette? I think it's tied with another one. But this is just... This is just such a good palette. Honestly. So... I'm pretty basic with this color story. So what I actually do is I use the gray matte. And then I deepen it up with the black. And then usually the shade Smoking goes on my lid. If I kind of feel fancy and I want a little bit more dimension. This one goes not specifically in the inner corner. But on my lid. But then in the inner part of my lid. To give a little bit of dimension. And then as I said, in the summer I combine it with neon. So I put a bright yellow pencil. And then really a pop of neon in the inner corner. You know, yellow or with bright orange. I also love to do it this time of year with red. So a red eye pencil, a red bottom. And then, you know, a red highlighter in the inner corner. For New Year's, I would combine it with gold or dirty gold. You know, that kind of thing. And it's just such a good quality. Yeah, what can I say? I love a look like that. Especially if I think of going partying. Yeah, the last palette that I pulled is a palette that has more color to it, but it's also, it's the color combination that I find very, as the name implied, opulent, because I pulled this one, the Beauty Bay Age of Opulence palette. I think that this, just the way that they have set this up, it's not my ultimate New Year's Eve palette, but it just... I don't know, it just does something. It's just the color combination, the teal and then that particular kind of warmer, I don't want to say rose gold, but that more orangey gold. And then also with those purples that are in here, combining it, just the whole color story, the fact that you can do a neutral look if you want to for during the day and then really spruce it up again. I really, really like the quality. I know that for some people the shimmers crease, they didn't for me. But yeah. I think that the name is very, very apt. This is a very opulent... There is just something, you know, I don't know, New Year's Eve in New York. They are all in there. I have something with the 30s. I love that period of time. That's kind of what I see when I look at this palette. So yeah. That was it for today. That was it for today, for today's video. I hope you enjoyed it. I had a lot of fun pulling all these palettes and basically going a little bit, you know, off into my own world and partying in my head because, frankly, I don't have the energy. I hope that you have an amazing holiday season, that you have fantastic Christmas if you celebrate that. And if you don't celebrate, I hope you have an amazing weekend. Thank you so, so much for watching. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. Don't forget to leave me your perfect party palettes. Let me know down in the comments. And then I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. May you have a glorious weekend. Perfect holiday season, and I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.